فرحان قفا بينو للهلولة حد سلحطو محيلة ضربو شوفارة الليلة احنا جايين من كل مكان لصورة زينة البلدان زورو ونرجع فرحان
بجوت مغابة ربوتاي ديسي فاكتورال يون شمات דוד יוסף בן עדה הכהן שהיום פקידת שלנו. על העין ישמעת יצחק בן מצליח שהגיע נשמעת בגן עדן. פשוט הרב שאלית, today parasha and last week parasha, next week parasha, we're talking about the exile of the Bnei Israel to Egypt. It's begin with Yaakov Avinu. Yaakov Avinu was the first one to go with his children to Eretz Mitzrayim. And there, they started the Galut Mitzrayim till Hashem sent Moshe Avinu to deliver them. But Rabotai, with the permission of Hashem, I would like just to ask you something. The Gemara said that Yaakov Avinu, he lost his nevuah. He was a big one of the biggest prophets. And he lost his nevuah because he was not happy. You know, to be a prophet, to be a prophet, to see things only if you are happy. Only if you are happy. If you're not happy, you lose your nevuah. And we have a lot of proof from Elisha Navi. We have proof from Yaakov Avinu. Since he heard that Yosef HaTzadik, he died or he disappeared, he cried so much, so he lost his prophecy during 22 years. No nevuah. And we have a lot of proof of a lot of tzaddikim. Most of the tzaddikim always did sing. Why? Because the Torah said, "Ivdu et Hashem b'simcha." You have to serve Hashem with happiness, with joy. And the simcha, when you are happy, so Bibrat, especially today, with the parnasa today, it's not so. Not everybody has a good parnasa, but. And we can see people that they make a lot of money, some people do not make a lot of money, people have a beautiful house, some people they don't have a house. But, a man who is satisfied of what Hashem gave him, you know, a few weeks ago, a lot of times people they come to ask me, Rabbi David, want a bracha to be rich, to have a house, and I want to be like my friend. And he mentioned a friend. I said, look, maybe your friend, he deserves more than you. So, why you're not right to tell me this. It's like an ara. It's like you're making an ara about your friend. So that means, Rabotai, if do it Hashem b'simcha, you must serve HaKadosh Baruch Hu with happiness. So my friend, my question is that the Bnei Israel in Egypt, when they started to be a slave in Egypt. Of course, there is no simcha there. Have you seen in your life a slave, a man that he's a slave and he's happy? Impossible. And even though that we see that the Bnei Israel, they pray to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, ve'itza'ako el Hashem, v'ta'al shavatam el ha'elukim. When they pray to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, HaKadosh Baruch Hu accepted their tefillah. But still, it misses there the happiness of the tefillah. There was no happiness. And even though that Hashem, he accepted the tefillah. So I want to understand, what is the difference between this and Yaakov? We know that because he was not happy, so he lost his nevuah. How the nevuah came, I was telling to some friends this morning, how the nevuah came to Yaakov Avinu, his prophecy came back. It happened, when they find Yaakov, Yosef HaTzadik, he met with his brothers and told them, I am Yosef, and then they meet Shalom, so they came back to Eretz Canaan. They had a problem. What to tell Yaakov? How to to give him the good news that Yosef, he is alive, and he's a tzaddik, and he was not, has v'shalom, be assimilated to the Egyptian. How can we tell? Maybe he will die from this happiness. It's a certain happiness. It could be very dangerous for him. So they had a nice idea. Serah bat Asher. They had the daughter of Asher. Asher, the son of Yaakov Avinu, she had a beautiful voice. Mamash, a beautiful voice. They decided to ask her to sing to Yaakov Avinu. Till that moment, Yaakov, he was not ready to listen in his songs, nothing. Just he was mourning, he was avilut about Yosef, his son. He was so bad, he was not happy. So they decided, Sarah, she has a special way how to compose a song for Yaakov Avinu. And she came to Yaakov. Yaakov was sitting, of course, he was learning Torah. And she started to sing about Yosef, that Yosef is alive, that Yosef is a tzaddik, that Yosef, Baruch Hashem, is a king. And Yaakov was listening. He was so much impressed, and he started to be happy. And then he saw that the Ruach HaKodesh came back to him, the Nevoah, the Bovin, came back to him, and he saw that Yosef is a king, and he saw that Yosef is a tzaddik. He was so happy, he called Sarah, and he gave her a bracha that she will never die. That she will never, so she is among the 10 people, like Eliyahu Navi, the Bishwa Ben Levi, 10 people that the Malach HaMavet, he cannot touch them. So my friend is, I would like just to ask you another question. Because she gave a good news, so she deserved this bracha. So that means, if I tell somebody, hey, you won the lotto, you're a billionaire now, he's going to be happy. So do you think, if he blessed me because he's happy, because I give him a good news, so I will live all my life? Have you seen a rabbi, a big tzaddik, giving up such a bracha to somebody to live all his life? Impossible. But Yaakov Avinu, Yaakov, he has known other bracha, just life, just to give life to Serah Bat Asher. Why? What happened exactly? Why Yaakov, he decided to give this such bracha to Sarah? Why? I mean, he can't give her bracha to have a good mazal, to have a lot of children, to have a long life, 1,000 years, but not life till Mashiach, he will come, she will still alive. Why? Rabotai, listen to this. The Torah said, Hibdu et Hashem b'simcha. You have to serve Hashem with happiness. Rav Shai Amar, he gave me this book this morning. No, just he showed me this book. And I don't know why he gave me this book. I have this book, Baruch Hashem, in Paris. Somebody gave it to me 2 years ago. It's a big mikubal, Rabbi Yaakov Fegan, Alav Shalom, who wrote it. But just I opened it. I wrote it this morning at 5 o'clock. I was writing at Dvar Torah, but I needed something for my Dvar Torah. I wrote something on Kabbalah this morning, but I needed something to make my Dvar Torah perfect. And now, just open it. Look what he said here. Da, look. Ki binyan gufa Adam en ra'oi likane b'shem Adam shel. A man is built with a body. And this man, he cannot be a perfect man. Only if all his body, the Evarim and the Gidim, they will be perfect. And how they can be perfect? Only through the Torah Kedusha. And without that, all his body is perfect, this man is not perfect. So we might think, I am a perfect, I'm okay, I'm right, I'm good. Hey, sir, if you really want to be Adam Shalem, if you want really to be a perfect man, you should have all your body, your fingers, perfect. Even your finger, he respects Torah. Not only he studied Torah. Now, all your body, the vein, the member. Mamash, where there is 630 mitzvot, can you get that equivalent of the Evarim and the Gidim on the body? 613. If they are perfect, as a we just this morning, beside the light, when the Torah is the light, and when you study Torah, so the this light it becomes more lighter. So that means, Rabotai, the Torah is a light. But when you study Torah, you respect the Torah, so the Torah become should be. You don't become only light. You light the light. The more you study Torah, you light the light. You light the light. There is no end. Rabotai, imagine Yaakov Avinu. Yaakov Avinu, he was Shalem. The Torah said that Yaakov was perfect. And even with Lavan, he respected the 613 mitzvot. He was much perfect. All his body was perfect. But those 22 years, of course he served Hashem. Of course he studied Torah. Of course he was a good man. But he needed some light. The missing of Yosef. That put something, a hisaron in his body. Something was missing on him. Beseder, he was a big tzaddik, Yaakov, but even that in his own way was happy. But he did not have the Shekhinah. He did not have the Nevoah. He lost the Nevoah. That means that his Avodat Hashem, it was not 100%. And Yaakov, that he is the symbol of the perfection, and that moment he needed something in his own perfection. I think in a way we can be the most perfect man in the world or everything, we will not reach Yaakov Avinu in 1%. Because Yaakov Avinu, his picture is hanging in front of Hashem. Hashem, every second he sees the picture of Yaakov Avinu. In front of him, Hashem, he sees Yaakov Avinu smiling. But during those 22 years, Yaakov was not smiling. His picture was there, but he was not smiling. He needed something. Rabotai, can you imagine how much Yaakov suffered for that? Who gave him back this happiness? Sarah. Sarah, she came and she started to sing. And because she gave him such happiness that Yaakov, through her song, that Yosef is alive, and the Nevoah came, at that moment, Yaakov Avinu, he repaired the 22 years that he was missing. All those 22 years that Yaakov Avinu, he had something missing on him, he repaired that moment. For that, there is no price. What is the price? Life. He gave her life. There was somebody who came to my father, Alav Shalom, for a bracha. And my father, Alav Shalom, he told him only one thing. Tadchak, are you happy? If you're happy, you don't need my bracha. If you're happy, you don't need my bracha. Bemet, Rabotai, this is the truth. Yaakov Avinu, Alav Shalom, he reached so a level of happiness at that second, that the Shekhinah came and he saw everything. All what he missed during 22 years, he saw in 1 second, he saw everything. He repaired everything. He repaired the missing of Avodat Hashem b'Simcha that he needed. So Rabotai, he gives Sarah Bat Asher something that you cannot imagine. Rabotai, now you have to understand, the best life of Yaakov Avinu, it was in Egypt. Why the best life, the 17 years of Yaakov Avinu, why they were the best in Egypt? Why they were the best? You know why? Because in those 22 years that he was missing the Ivdut Hashem b'Simcha, to serve Hashem with happiness, and now, Baruch Hashem, everything is back. Now in Egypt, he sees all his family, Shumrim Torah v'Mitzvot, and he sees all his family with Shalom and peace with Yosef. Imagine, his Simcha, it doubled. It was only a Simcha that he had before. Now it tripled, it doubled. Until he wanted to tell the Am Israel, he wanted to tell them exactly when Mashiach is going to come. He was so much happy. He wanted to tell them who was the cause of all this. Sarah Bat Asher. So she deserved it, Rabotai, this kind of simcha. That was the parasha of this week. Ve'elei Shemot Bin Israel. What they did the Jews in Egypt? That they were not assimilated, they did not change their clothes, and they did not change their names, and they did not change their language, and they were mamash. They were mamash, as the Torah says, Elei Shemot Benia. This is their names. This is their name. That means that what hold them in Egypt. Not who this face of Yaakov, the Simcha. You know, Rabotai, just imagine when a tzaddik give you a smile. You will never forget it. In my life, I had some few smiles from some tzaddikim. Up to now, I will not forget them. Be'emet, huh? Often when I think of them, it reminds me, it gives me life. And they die already, they die 40 years ago. And up to now, this simcha that I saw their face, it affects a lot on me. What they can imagine, 17 years Yaakov Abinu was smiling, 17 years was happy, 17 years all Jews, they were in Egypt, they saw him, that smiling of Yaakov, that happiness of Yaakov, that came through Serach Bat Asher, that Rabotai give them the strength to live in Egypt till they were delivered from Egypt. Because Rabotai, Rabbi Shai Amar, tomorrow is his birthday, I would like just Alav Shalom, Rabbi Pinchas HaKohen, as well, it's a Hilula. I would like just to tell a beautiful story of Rabbi Pinchas HaKohen, Alav Shalom. He was a big tzaddik, he was Baal Ruach HaKodesh. He was very, very well known that he see everything. He was very, very well known. That Mamash, as a matter of fact, I don't know if you know or not, that Glawi, Glawi was the Pasha of Marrakesh. And the Pasha of Marrakesh was like the governor. When Mohammed had the king of Morocco, Mohammed V, who was destituted from the French, and they took him to Madagascar. So the Glawi, they put the Glawi to hold, to be like the king. But he was loyal to the king of Mohammed V. He was very loyal to the king. He did not touch his place. One day, some people, they wanted to kill him. And they put his milk, because everyone used to drink a milk. And Rabbi Pinchas HaKohen, he was his friend. He came to the palace early in the morning. And when he saw him, the guards saw him, they respected him. He told them, go tell the Glawi, the governor, I want to see him. The Glawi was surprised. Rabbi, what's the problem? He told him, don't drink this morning the milk that he will bring you. Give it to a dog, he will drink it, you will see what's going to happen. And they stayed together in the palace. He asked for his breakfast. He bring the breakfast for him and a cup of tea for Rabbi Pinchas HaKohen. And then Rabbi Pinchas HaKohen to the king, bring the dog or the cat. And they give them the milk. They drink the milk. A few minutes later, he died, the dog. So, of course, that was his Ruach HaKodesh, he was a prophet. And it's very well known that Rabbi Pinchas HaKohen always was smiling. As I told you, Baal Shem Tov was smiling, he was happy. All the tzaddik, even if you see the Lubavitch Rebbe, always he was smiling. All tzaddikim that they smile, they have the zechut to have Ruach HaKodesh. They have, or even if they don't, maybe they don't know that they have Ruach HaKodesh. Maybe they don't know that they are prophet. But they say things that all what they say is true. Maybe they don't know that they have Ruach HaKodesh. But what they say, it happened. When the Rabbi Pinchas HaKohen every year, before he go to Rabbi David and Baruch HaVashem Tarudent, where he do the Hilula of his grandfather, he used to, because to go from Marrakesh to Tarudent, there is a junction. You have here, you come from Marrakesh, you have Issawira, Agadir Tarudent. So every year he comes to Issawira, he brings his kupa, tzedakah, to Rabbi Chaim Pinto, my grandfather, and this talks of the Torah, and it happened that he has no time, so he decided to go to Agadir, and after he will come back to Issawira, and the car broke. They cannot move. He stopped in dejection. So they waiting, and they saw from far away somebody come in. Kuchi, how do you call Kuchi? It was in Sawera, huh? Yeah, it was in Sawera, no taxi, Kuchi, you know, horse with horses to Agala. So Rabbi Haipidu was there with his shamash. And they arrived, Rabbi Hazakoy was very happy to meet him. They started to talk. And Rabbi Haipidu told him, why this time you decided not to come to see me as every year? He said, because I was in a hurry. The car broke. He said, well, because you did not come to see me, so it broke. Because the guy used to come to see me first. So Rabbi Hazakoy asked Rabbi Haipidu, so now I'm sorry, he's the Kupa. We started to talk some, each one give a bracha, they give brachot tzaddikim, everyone give bracha to the others. Even Rabbi Haipidu, he give him his pidyon. This is a tzaddikim, each one give the pidyon to the other one. And then what happened? It happened that Rabbi Haipidu, he took his makel, his stick, and he hit the car, and he told Rabbi Hazakoyen, tell the driver now to start the car. And he started the car, and they drive, and they went. He says, Rabotai, the same thing happened with my father. He met the first time Baba Sadi, alav shalom. Because my brother behind me is married to the daughter of Baba Mir. Baba Mir, alav hasar, alav shalom, that he was the father of Rabbi Azar, Rabbi David, Rabbi Kutel, Rabbi Raphael. And one day, they decided that my father Baba said to meet. They already meet a few times, but now I'm meeting in his house. And my father prepared an envelope. And he put there 500 shekel. Pidyon for Baba Saleh. And they sit together, they talk. And then Baba Saleh says, well, give a pidyon to my father. You know how much he gave him? 500. The same amount that my father gave him. 500. So my father was laughing. He said, you see, he did not lose, I did not lose. Nothing. There is another story about Rabbi Haipidu with Rabbi Pinchas HaKohen, that one day Rabbi Pinchas HaKohen, he was his driver, Yehia HaKohen, Alav HaShalom from Morocco, he's very well known in Casablanca, he has a synagogue. He drove him to Agadir, to Abidon, and the car had a crash. And at that moment that the car was turning, Rabbi Pinchas HaKohen, it was near Isawira. He said, Rabbi Haipidu, Rabbi Haipidu, Rabbi Haipidu. That is Rabbi HaKohen, the driver, who told me the story. So Baruch Hashem, the car, when he turned the last time, he came back to his level and they carry on driving. So HaKohen asked Rabbi Pinchas HaKohen, why didn't call the zichut of your grandfather, Rabbi David Ben Baruch? Why you call Rabbi Haipidu? You know what it was his answer? A fantastic answer. An answer that, how much you have to respect this answer. That's why, I'll tell you after. What was his answer? He said, here we are the district of Rabbi Haipidu. So the only one that I have to call, it's Rabbi Haipidu. If the accident would happen near Tarudan, I will call Rabbi David Baruch. I learned from that story, when you come to this place, it's Chabad, you have to respect. You have to respect. If you go to Sadmar, you have to respect. If you are Ashkenaz, and you go to Asfarad, Sfaradim, you have to respect. Wherever you are, you have to respect the place. You have to respect the zichut of the shul that it belongs. You have to respect. You cannot change. This is the perfect man. You know, Rabotai, Yaakov Abino Alav Shalom. As we said now, Binyan Guf Adam En Ra'oi Likare B'Shem Adam Shalem. Ela K'shi Shalem B'Chlal Evarav Kulam Shehem Rabah. What it is a perfect man, only if all his body is perfect, he respected all the mitzvot B'Simcha. And Yaakov Abino, of course he did it, but something was missing. Because Yosef was not here. So now, even that he was a big tzaddik, but something was missing. He needed Ruach HaKodesh in his body. That was missing. So Sarah, but Hashem, she gave him this opportunity to have back all what he missed for doing 22 years. He gave her a such a bracha, b'simcha, b'tovle, with a good heart. And that's, it was no price for what she did for him. You understand? What she did for him. Look at me. If I give you the numbers of the lotto, you win billions. There is no price for you to give me. Because what I did for you, it's a, you are a billionaire for thousands of years. That's money. But can you imagine, for Yaakov Avinu, he doesn't care about money. What Yaakov cares a lot is Avodat Hashem, how to serve HaKadosh Baruch Hu, how to be connected, to repair what he lost during 22 years. And Serah Bat Asher, she gave him that. She gave him that good news. Especially when he saw the Agalot. But Tehiruach Yaakov, when his children, they came, and they told him, Papa, you know Yosef is alive, and he's a tzaddik. There was no end. There was no end of his happiness. Rabotai, this is the parasha. Now we understand, Rabotai, this simcha of Yaakov Abinu Alav Shalom, it give it as an heritage to his children that they remain in Egypt. And that would help them during the 210 years of salvation in Egypt not to be assimilated, because every time they remember Yaakov Abinu, probably the fathers, they teach the children, you know, Yaakov probably told the children all what happened with Yaakov Avinu when he lost the Nebuah. The Nebuah came back, and then he gave a bracha to Sarah. And Sarah, she was there. I'm sure that people used to go to Sarah to ask her, but because she didn't die. Tell us, Sarah, what happened? Why you are alive? And she told them. So that's what this good news that Sarah she gave to Yaakov Avinu, and Yaakov Avinu, the bracha he gave her, that was very, very well known. You know, as just to finish, I heard that Sarah Bat Asher, she was the one who told Yaakov, Moshe Rabbeinu, the place where Yosef was buried. Because no one knew where he was buried. Sarah Bat Asher. Because she didn't die. Besides what he did, Yaakov Yosef Moshe Rabbeinu to discover the Aaron of Yosef, but Sarah as well, she was a wish you, pray for you that HaKadosh Baruch Hu give you bracha v'atzlacha, v'yud ken ratzon, v'zichut of Rabbi Peter, Rabbi Pinchas, HaKohen Alav Shalom, be with you, and I'll be worthy to have Shai Amal.
على ربي حي